If it's a drug cult, you'd think the Pharisees would know that. Mm-hmm. And would be shooting it down so fast that Christianity wouldn't have had a chance to grow.
Oh, it'd be discredited instantly if it was a drug cult.
Instead of one of them joining it.
And that's why they think that the people that advocate for the drug cult aspect say that it was a hidden drug cult, that they were hiding it in art and allegory and whatnot, rather than being direct about it, because they would have been persecuted. But the main focus of secular people arguing against the resurrection isn't that it was drugs. They think they were hallucinating because of excitement or expectation or depression or anxiety or something like that. And there are cases of people hallucinating due to that, due to those sorts of stimulations. But the problem here is we have lots of people all hallucinating the same thing, and they're all coming from different backgrounds. So Peter and Paul were supposed to be guilty and remorseful. Mary was supposed to be distressed and fearful. The other disciples were supposed to have been excited and in expectation. You have them all in different locations, in different situations, with different psychological motivations, and they're all going to hallucinate the exact same thing at the exact same time, in some cases, over a period of 40 days, right? And it dramatically changed their lives. Like, this just... It doesn't have all the hallmarks of hallucinations at that point.